Welcome to Vani Sudhir online classes. Today we'll introduce trigonometry. Let me pay the presentation for you. What is the picture about? Yes, it is a mice sliding in a park. Let us suppose in a park there are two slides to play. Observe that there will be right angle triangles shape in each slide as shown. Here AC is the length of the slide, which is same in both slides, and BC is the height of the ladder. And AB is the horizontal distance between the foot of both slide and ladder. And BAC is the angle between slide AC and the horizontal distance AB. Now, can you guess which slide is more apt for very small children? In slide 1, angle BAC is smaller, so the height of the ladder is also less, and the horizontal distance is more. So it is apt for small children to climb easily and to slide slowly, as the slope is less when compared to slide 2. Next, in slide 2, whereas in slide 2, the angle is increased. So height, ladder height is more and horizontal distance is less. So it is not easy to climb, but the big children can slide fast as the slope is more when compared to slide 1. You can also fix the slide in such a way that the ladder length and horizontal distance are equal. We can observe that there is some relation between angle and the sides of a triangle. This is only one example showing the application part of triangle in our daily life. And we have many applications like measure of heights, distance, and slope by using the properties of triangle. These type of problems are part of our trigonometry, which is an important branch of mathematics. It contains three Greek words: tri means three, gonia means angle, metri or metron means measures. So altogether, trigonometry means three angles measures. Now let us name sides of right angle triangle. Take triangle ABC, right angle at B. The side opposite to right angle AC is hypotenuse. Now name the angle BAC with a Greek letter theta. So its position is opposite to BC. So the side BC is opposite to angle A or theta. So opposite side to theta is BC, and the remaining side AC is adjacent side. So adjacent side to theta is AB. We can also describe adjacent side like the side close to theta other than hypotenuse. Now what happens if theta is taken in the place of AC? Now, can you name the sides of right angle triangle? Because yes, they are not the same as discussed earlier, because we are taking the angle at a different position. Hypotenuse may be same, but the angle opposite to theta is AB now. Opposite side to theta is AB, and now the adjacent side to theta is BC. Have you observed? Who am I? That means, who is the champion? The champion is the student who can identify the opposite side and adjacent side of an angle in a right angle triangle without any confusion. Now let us do some activity for trigonometric ratios. First, we'll draw a horizontal line with initial point O. Mark the points A, B, C at a distance of 1, 2, and 3 centimeters respectively. Now, dry ray OX such a way that COX is 60 degrees. You can take other angles also. Now mark points P, Q, R at a distance of 2, 4 and 6 centimeters respectively. Now join AP as it looks like perpendicular. Join BQ, it's look perpendicular for OC. Join CR, it is perpendicular to OC. So now make a table. See here, their OAP is a right angle triangle in which the adjacent side OA is 1. OBC is another right angle triangle in which the adjacent side OB is 2. OCR is another right angle triangle in which the adjacent side OC is 3. And the hypotenuse OP in triangle OAP, OP will be 2. In triangle OBQ, the hypotenuse OQ is 4. In triangle OCR, the hypotenuse OR is 6. Now find the ratio of adjacent side to hypotenuse. In triangle OAP, it is half. In triangle OBQ, 2 upon 4 is also half. In triangle OCR, 3 upon 6, that is also half. See, the side lengths are not same. Even though side lengths are not same, but the ratio of adjacent side to hypotenuse is same. Isn't it surprising? Here, OAP is right angle, OBQ is right angle, and OCR is also right angle at C. And angle O is the common angle for OAP and OBQ and OCR. Therefore, the triangle OAP, triangle OBQ, and triangle OCR similar triangles by AA similarity criteria. These criteria and all we'll discuss in similarity concepts in triangle chapter. Then the sides ratios OA upon OP will be equal to the sides ratio in another triangle, corresponding sides ratios will be OP, OB upon OQ. This is also equal to the another corresponding sides of triangle OCR, that is OC upon OR. We have already seen in the table they are equal to half. This ratios can be named as sine of that angle, sine of that O, sine of 60 degrees. Sine of, see here adjacent side to hypotenuse is cosine of that angle. Cosine of that 60 degrees is half. That can be OAP triangle, that can be OBQ triangle or OCR triangle. Cosine of 60 degrees is half. Okay. Similarly, the ratio of opposite side of an angle and the length of the hypotenuse are also constant in a similar triangles, in all similar triangles. This ratio can be named as sine of that angle. Next, the ratio of opposite side to adjacent side of an angle is also constant and it can be named as tangent of that angle. Here, who am I? Who is the champion? Who can understand the value of a given ratio for an angle is independent of the actual length of the side of a triangle, but it depends only on the ratio of the lengths of the two sides involved in it. Next, the important section, very, very important. You have to define the trigonometric ratios. They are the ratio of the sides of a right angle triangle. First, you have to take a triangle, right angle triangle ABC, right angle at B. Here BAC, we are taking theta at the angle BAC. Next, first ratio will be sine of angle A. That is simply you can write, in simple we can say sine A. It is the ratio of length upon side opposite to angle A upon length of the hypotenuse. Here opposite angle, side opposite to A, angle A is BC, BC upon AC it is. Next, trigonometric ratio, cosine of angle A. In simple, we can say cos A. That will be the ratio of sides, length of the side adjacent to A, angle A, to length of hypotenuse. Here adjacent side to theta is AB upon AC. Next, tangent of angle A. In simple, we can say tan A. That will be the ratio of length of the side opposite to angle A to length of the side adjacent to angle A, that is BC upon AB. If we remember this three trigonometric ratio, we can define another three trigonometric ratios which are reciprocals of these three ratios. Cosecant of angle A, that will be the reciprocal, cosec A in simple, that will be the reciprocal of sin A. If sin A is BC by AC, this will be AC upon BC. Next, secant of ing, that will be reciprocal of cos. Cos is AB upon AC, no? This will be AC upon AB. Next, cotangent of A, or in simple, cot A, is reciprocal of tan. Tan A. Tan A, we got BC upon AB. Then this will be AB upon BC. Who is the champion here? Who am I? The students who can memorize this trigonometric ratio, they are the champions. Because these ratios are foundation for trigonometry. And also I have taken, it is my pleasure to take my teacher name, N.M. Rao sir, who is all-time favorite teacher for all my colleagues in my previous organization. Now let us solve some problems. Now in a right angle triangle A, angle B is 90 degrees. Sin A ratio is given 9 upon 15. Given sin A is 9 upon 15. See, it is not in lowest terms. They are not co-primes because 3 is common factor. You can divide both numerator and denominator with 3. You can express in lowest terms, that is 3 upon 5. Sin A means it is a ratio of the sides, length of the side opposite to A upon length of the hypotenuse. Here, for A, for angle A, what is opposite side? For angle A, BC will be opposite side, that is 3. This ratio is given 3 upon 5. Opposite side ratio to hypotenuse is 3 upon 5. For angle A, opposite side is BC. According to the ratio, you can take 3 times K. Hypotenuse, according to the ratio, you can take 5 times K. Hypotenuse is AC, the side opposite to B, 90 degrees. Here, K is any positive number, a real constant. Now we have in triangle ABC, right angle at B, we can apply the Pythagoras formula. The hypotenuse square is equal to sum of squares of other two sides. Here BC value you can take 3K, AC value you can substitute 5K. 3K you can transpose to that side, minus 3K square it will become. 25K whole square means, 5K whole square means it is 25K square. 3K whole square means it is 9K square. If you subtract, we'll get 16K square. This is AB square value. Then AB value will be 4 times K. AB is nothing but the adjacent side to angle A. Now we can determine the other trigonometric ratio. Cos A, how we define? Adjacent side to A upon hypotenuse. Adjacent side A just now we found, that is 4K, and hypotenuse is 5K. So when it is expressed in lowest terms, it is 4 upon 5. Next, how we define tan A? It is opposite side of A to adjacent side of A. Opposite side is 3 times K, adjacent side 4K, 4 times K. Then this trigonometric ratio will be 3 upon 4. Now cosec A, it is the reciprocal of sine. You can write sine is 3 upon 5. No, it is 5 upon 3 then. Sec A is reciprocal of cos. Cos we got 4 upon 5, then this will be 5 upon 4. Next, cot A, it is reciprocal of tan. Tan is 3 upon 4. No, this is 4 upon 3. Let us solve one more problem. Here, a right angle triangle PQR is given. Angle P is 90 degrees. PQ, one side is given. But the sum of the other two sides is given. We have to determine the value of sine square P plus cos square P and sine square R plus cos square R. We have given a triangle PQR in which Q is 90 degrees. You can apply Pythagoras formula. The side opposite to QPR will be hypotenuse. Hypotenuse square will be equal to sum of squares of other two sides. PQ value, you know, 5, you can substitute 5 square it is. QR, you can transpose to that side, minus QR square. Here you can apply the identity A square minus B square. That is A plus B into A minus B. PR plus QR value is given 25, that you can substitute. Now 25 equal to 25 times PR minus QR, then PR minus QR will be 1. you are having sum of the two sides PR and QR 25, and now we got difference of two sides, that is 1. We can solve this and we can find PR and QR values. If you add them, QR will get cancelled. Twice PR will be 26. Then PR is half of 26, that is 30. If you substitute this in PR plus QR value, PR plus QR, that is 25, then you will get QR value 12, that is 25 minus 30, 12. We can solve in another way also. Instead of using A square minus B square identity, you can take in QR plus 25 minus PR, because the sum is given 25. You can apply the identity A minus B whole square. If you solve, then also you will get PR value 13 and QR value 12. Now let us determine the trigonometric ratio sine P. That means opposite side to P to hypotenuse. For P, what will be the opposite side? QR upon PR. QR how much? We got 12, we found, and hypotenuse 13. PR. Cos P, adjacent side to P upon hypotenuse. Adjacent side to P will be PQ. Hypotenuse is PR. PQ, it is there in question itself. That is 5. And hypotenuse is 13. Cos P is 13 upon 5 upon 30. Next, sine R. Sine R is not as same as sine PC. Here, opposite side to RC. Opposite to R means this PQ. It is PQ upon PR, that is 5 upon 13. Now, cos R. Adjacent side to R upon hypotenuse. That is, adjacent side to R is QR upon PR. QR, how much we are having? 12 upon 13 it is. Now we'll find the value of sine square P plus cos square P. Sine P value 12 upon 13, then sine square P will be 12 upon 13 whole square. Cos P value is 5 upon 13. Cos square P will be 5 upon 13 whole square. Whole square means both numerator and denominator are squared. That is, we'll get 12 by 13 whole square means 144 upon 169 we'll get. 5 by 13 whole square means 25 upon 169 we'll get. 169 we can take LCM. If we add 144 plus 25, that is also 169. So 116 upon 169 is 1. Similarly, sine square plus cos square also you can find. That means these two values will be interchanged. That 5 by 13 whole square plus 12 by 13 whole square will come. Similarly, you can solve and you can get the its value as 1 only. Please mail us to ssudhir@gmail.com. Give your feedback and request for the concepts to be prioritized. Please and like and subscribe for more videos. Thank you and Jai Hind.